Okay, Kathy, so it's month 8 in the rapidly elapsing calendar. So August, first of all, if anybody watching has not gotten all of their ducks in a row regarding their Thanksgiving initiative, now is a great time to pounce on that. But Kathy, what else should people be considering in terms of their card sending initiatives this time of year?
So August is the time to think about fourth quarter birthdays. And I encourage people to, if you talk to me on the phone, I encourage people to find a signature image for that year. So it might be a male birthday, a female birthday. But once you're done using that card for that year, then you won't go back and use that card again, because you don't want to send that same card to people the next year and the year after and the year after. You don't remember them, because getting a card in the mail is a little bit rare. So, you know, if you open up the same card, you'll be like, oh, that's really pretty. Didn't I get that last year? So we just finish up with whatever fourth quarter birthdays, and then those cards are done, and you won't see them again unless you have a few left in your desk. Anniversaries. So this is a really good time to just, you know what, you've got some time, check your database. You know, you've got different anniversaries for people. We've got, like I said, you can use just a really beautiful landscape, some florals. We've got really cute little Scrabble tiles that spell out happy anniversary that I'm pretty sure in your house, Duncan, would be popular. We'll have to get you one of those cards for your anniversary. And then you have some other anniversaries, Duncan, that you like to send cards for or ask your clients to send cards for.
Yeah, so something that's sort of not commonly recognized is a business relationship anniversary, especially if it's a milestone. I mean, if you've got a client and you've been working together for 10 years, it's not a bad idea to say, hey, this has been a great 10 years. I really appreciate the relationship and I'm looking forward to the next 10 years. I mean, that's a nice touch. The wedding anniversary concept for clients is great as well. And it reminds me of the importance of consistency, because I had a client who said that he used to send out anniversary cards, and what happened was he stopped. And one of his clients called him up and said, hey, thanks a lot. You used to send us an anniversary card. It would remind me it's our anniversary. And now I'm in the doghouse. So just a little gentle reminder about the importance of consistency.
Yeah, and I think that's true, Duncan. You know, once you start a greeting card campaign, it's hard to go backwards from there, because people go, wait a minute, what about me? Like, you used to send me cards and now you don't send me cards anymore. So it's a slippery slope. I love that people send out, you know, cards for all these different anniversaries. And I really like that idea of like a 10th year anniversary for a business relationship. That's one I hadn't really thought of before, but I'm going to put that in my bag of tricks.
Perfect. This is Duncan MacPherson with Pareto Systems, along with Kathy Durrell at Lavish Cards. This is one actionable idea that you can put into your scheduled calendar or client relationship management using high quality cards from Lavish Cards. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. Thanks, Duncan.